Hello, welcome to Garage Guru. Now, we are starting with a new session, with a new chapter, that is time series analysis. Now, the word itself is time series, time. So, this word is itself. Now, what is time series? So, it is, I'll say a time series is a sequence of values of a phenomenon arranged in order of their occurrence. Matlab, according to the time, that is arranged in a chronological order, we can say. So, ये हो गया basic meaning of the term what? Time series. Mathematically, it can be expressed as a function. Namely, y is equal to f of t. Where t represents time and y represents the corresponding values. That is the value y1, y2, y3, ... of a phenomenon with respect to time period t1, t2, t3, ... for a time series. So, ये हो गया basic meaning of the term what? Time series. Now, after this, the next condition is component of a time series. Now, this is an important question from short note point of view. Now, there are certain questions which comes for a short note in your maths paper as well. So, over here, first condition I'll say component of a time series. So, what is the meaning of this? I'll say the fluctuation in time series are due to one or more of the following factors which are called component of time series. I'll say the first one is secular train. So I will say what is secular train. So secular train ka meaning hota hai, I'll say the general tendency of data either to increase, to decrease or to remain constant is called secular train. It is smooth long term movement of data. The changes in the values are gradual and continuous. An increasing demand for luxury items like refrigerator or color TV sets reflects increasing trend. The production of steel, cement, vehicles shows a rising trend. On the other hand, decrease in import of food grains is an example of decreasing trend. The nature of the trend may be linear or curvilinear. In practice, curvilinear trend is more common. Trend in due to long-term tendency, hence it can be evaluated if the time series is available over a long duration. So this was the first component. Now the second component is seasonal variation. So I'll say the regular seasonal changes in time series are called seasonal variation. So again, this is basic meaning of the term what seasonal variation. Again, you will see this on the screen. Now, after this, it is observed that the demand for umbrellas, raincoat, reaches a peak during what? Monsoon. Or the advertisement of cold drinks, ice creams, get a boom in what? Summer. The demand for greeting cards, sweets increases during festivals like Diwali, Christmas, etc. In March, there is maximum withdrawal of bank deposit for adjustment of income tax payment. So, also various tax saving schemes shoot up during this period. The causes for this seasonal fluctuation are thus the changes in weather condition, the traditions and custom of people, etc. The seasonal component is measured to isolate these changes from the trend component and to study their effects so that in any business, future production can be planned accordingly and necessarily adjustments for seasonal changes can be made. So, ye ho gaya second component. Now, third one is cyclic variation. Cyclic variation, the name itself suggests, these are changes in a time series occurring over a period which is more than a year. They are recurring and periodic in nature. The period may not be uniform. These fluctuations are due to changes in business cycle. There are four component phases of any business activity. Like, it will have what? Prosperity as one of the phase, recession, depression and recovery. During prosperity, the business flourishes and the profit reaches a maximum level. Thereafter in recession, the profit decreases, reaching a minimum level during depression. After some time period, the business again recovers and it is followed by period of prosperity. Variation in this time series due to these phases in a business cycle are called as what? Cyclic variation. And now the fourth one, fourth type of variation is irregular variation. or we also say it is also called as what? Random variation. The changes in time series which cannot be predicted is called as irregular variation. Usually, these are short-term changes having significant effect on the time series during the time that time interval. These are caused by unforeseen events like wars, floods, strike, political changes, etc. So basically, we cannot say war is going on every day. So war is an irregular variation. Ye randomly kabhi bhi aa sakta hai. It's not necessary. Every day it is. Floods. So again, this is random. We can't say tomorrow flood will come. So yahan pe it depends upon certain situations. So all this are called as what? Random or irregular variation. So ye ho gaya basic meaning of the term what? Components of time series. So this were the four components of time series. So now next condition over here is analysis of time series. Now analysis of time series, this is another concept again. The purpose of studying time series is to estimate or forecast the values of the variable. As there are four components of time series, these are to be studied separately. There are two types of model which are used to express the relationship of components of time series. They are additive model and multiplicative model. I'll say let O is equal to original time series, T is equal to secular trends, S is equal to seasonal variation, C is equal to cyclic variation, and I is equal to irregular variation. In additive model, it is assumed that the effects of the individual components can be added to get the resultant value of the time series. That is, the components are independent of one another. The model can be expressed as O is equal to T plus S plus C plus I. So again, you'll be seeing this on the screen. That is, original time series is equal to T plus S plus C plus I. Now, I have mentioned what is O, T, C, S and I. In multiplicative model, it is assumed that multiplication of the individual effects of components results in time series. That is, the components are due to different causes, but they are not necessarily independent. So that changes in any one of them can affect the other components. This model is more commonly used. It is expressed as O is equal to T into S into C into I. If we want to estimate the values in time series, we have to first estimate the four components and then combine them to estimate the value of what? Time series. The irregular variation cannot be predicted, and hence estimates of first three components only can be found. However, we will restrict ourselves to discuss methods of estimating the first component, namely secular trend. So over here, this was analysis of time series. Now the next concept is estimation of trends. Among other methods of estimating the trends component of time series, method of freehand curve, moving average and least square methods are important methods. These methods are described as follows. I'll say the first method is freehand curve method. Now, name itself suggests, I will say it is free hand curve method. So this is the first method. Second method is method of moving average. I will say moving averages. Third one is method of least square. Now over here, हमने तीन method list किए. Now we'll be seeing first method, that is freehand curve method. So यहाँ पे freehand curve method के लिए we need to first have certain type of data. ठीक है, तो पहले मैं data read करता हूँ and फिर वो data को हमें plot करना है. So then we'll see the plotting of that and then we'll understand what is the method exactly. So I'll say fit a trend component for the following time series using freehand curve method का नाम है. year 1976 1977 78 79 80 81 82 83. Production of rice in 1000 tons 62 63 66 65 68 72 71 74. So these are the values. Now this values we need to plot. So yahan pe we'll see the plotting of this. So now this is method of what? Freehand curve method. So yahan pe kya tha, jo bhi data di hai wo humne plot kiya. I have plotted this ki 1976 mein 62 tha to 62 mark kiya, 77 mein 63 to wo mark kiya, same way 78 79 to jo data tha wo sab khali plot karke rakha hai. And the name suggests free hand curve. To ye sare values plot kiye. Ab ye plot karne ke baad ye jo points hai isko maine join kiya. Free hand bola hai, matlab I don't have to use what scale for this part. To ye maine sab join kiya free hand. So this is nothing but what? Free hand curve method. Theek hai, generally iska chances bahut kam hota hai, but then too we'll learn one sum based on it. ठीक है, तो वो हमने बेसिक कंडीशन देख लिया. एंड बेसिकली ये खाली ग्राफ का जैसे प्लॉटिंग होता है एक्स एंड वाई एक्सिस का, वैसे जस्ट खाली प्लॉट करना है. एंड लास्ट में हमें क्या करना है, वो पॉइंट्स को जॉइन करना है. एंड वी नीड टू चेक फॉर मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द पॉइंट्स कहाँ पे कवर हो रहे. ठीक है, तो ये हो गया फ्री हैंड कर्व मेथड, ये हो गया फर्स्ट मेथड हमारा. नाउ वी नीड टू मेक अ नोट ऑफ दिस मेथड. Now we'll be seeing the second method, that is method of moving averages. Now in order to understand method of moving averages, pehle iske basic conditions seekhne padenge. Evaluation of non-line strain is possible under this method. In this method, we first find arithmetic mean of first n values and represent it against the middle observation. Then the first value is deleted and the mean of next n observation is calculated. This procedure is continued till the last value is reached. The corresponding arithmetic mean represents the secular trend. The method is easy to calculate, but the trend values of first few years as well as last few years are not calculated. So there is a loss of information. Also, this method cannot be used to predict the future trend values. The period of moving averages can be 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, etc. If it coincides with the period of business cycle, then cyclic variations are completely eliminated. So over here, basically method of moving averages mein, we have 3 methods. First method is, I'll say 3 yearly moving average, then it is 4 yearly moving average and 5 yearly moving average. Now, in order to understand 3 yearly and 5 yearly, I'll say we have one category, 3, 5. So, these are odd category. So, ye ho jayega ek condition. 4 yearly moving average, ye ho jayega second category, that is even case mein jayega. Now, in order to understand this, we'll take one question based on it. So, humne jo graph plot kiya tha, that was question number 1. And now, method of moving averages mein, 3 yearly moving averages पे हम एक question देखते हैं, and that becomes a question number 2. So question number 2 says, calculate trend by considering 3 yearly moving average for the following time series of price indices for the year 2000 to 2006, year 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006. Price index 111, 115, 116, 118, 119, 120, 122. So over here, I will say, ye values diye gaye. Theek hai? Now in order to get the value for this, I'll write the first condition over here is year. Mera first column aa jayega year. Second column aayega, it is price index. So ये आ जाएगा यहां पे प्राइस एंड आई विल राइट इट एज व्हाट इंडेक्स. Now, after this, I'll write, since it is question based on 3-yearly moving average, so I'll write over here first, 3-yearly total. And next condition aayega, to main bolunga 3-yearly moving average. Theek hai, ye word. So over here, the year which is given is, I'll say 2000 se diya. So it is 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006. Value jo diye gaye hai, wo hai 111, 115, 116, 118, 119, 120 and 124. Sorry, 122. ठीक है, ये value दिया. Now we want 3-yearly total, 3-yearly moving average. ठीक है, method का नाम है. Now 3-yearly. तो अभी है ना, ये method में हमें समझना है कि इसके values कैसे list out करना है. Now, in order to get 3-yearly moving, 3-yearly total है, और 3-yearly moving average. Since मुझे 3-yearly moving average चाहिए, इसलिए मुझे पहले 3-yearly total चाहिए. अब 3-yearly, इसका मतलब क्या होता है? First, second, third. ये तीनों को मुझे add करना है. And ये तीनों को add करके, मुझे उसका value list out करना है कहाँ पे? उसके middle में. So, वैसा बोलूँगा, 2000, 2001, 2002. ये तीन साल का middle year कौन सा है? तो मैं बोलूँगा 2001. So, ये तीनों के वैल्यूज ऐड होके यहां पे टोटल लिखा जाएगा, दैट इज 2001 के सामने. सो आई विल से इट इज 111, मतलब 111 प्लस 115 प्लस 116. ये तीनों को ऐड करेंगे. ये तीनों को ऐड करने के बाद जो वैल्यू आया वो मुझे लिखना है कहां पे? उसके मिडल पे, मतलब 2000, 2001, 2002 के मिडल पे, मतलब 2001 के सामने. सो इट बिकम्स 342. अब नेक्स्ट होता है 2001, 2002, 2003. सो 1, 2, 3 अगेन. तो अब मैं बोलूंगा 115, 116 और 118. ये ऐड करके, ये लिस्ट डाउन करके कहां पे? 2002 के सामने, क्योंकि 2001, 2002, 2003 ये तीन का एडिशन कहां पे लिस्ट डाउन होगा? 2002 के सामने. सो इट इज 115 प्लस 116 प्लस इट इज 118. So addition of it is 349. So now for next 3 years. So मैं ऐसा बोलूँगा 2002, 2003, 2004. तो 116, 118, 119 ये सबको add करेंगे. 116 plus 118 plus 119. ठीक है, तो इसका total आ जाएगा 353. तो इसको लिखेंगे कहाँ पे? यहाँ पे. अब next है, जैसे ये हो गया 1, 2, 3, तो उसका हिसाब ने यहां पे लिखा. अभी नेक्स्ट होता है 2003, 4, 5. तो 118, 119, 120, 118, 119, 120. ठीक है, तो ये हो जाएगा 357. तो इसका वैल्यू कहां पे लिखेंगे? तो यहां पे आ जाएगा 357. नेक्स्ट जो वैल्यू है वो है 2004, 5, 6. सो 2004, 5, 6, तो इसके वैल्यू 119, 120, 122. ये तीन को ऐड करेंगे. सो इट इज 119 प्लस 120 प्लस 122. सो आंसर फॉर दिस इज 361. अब इसके बाद है ना, मेरे पास 2005 और 6 खाली दो ही साल है. मेरा मेथड है 3-yearly. तो इसके बाद मेरे पास तीन वैल्यूज है ही नहीं. सो दैट इज द रीजन, फर्स्ट वैल्यू में कुछ नहीं आ सकता है और लास्ट वैल्यू में कुछ नहीं आ सकता. सो अगर ये टोटल नहीं है तो ये एवरेज भी नहीं हो सकते. तो ये क्या, अब यहां पे जो टोटल आया है उसको मुझे क्या करना होगा? 3-yearly मूविंग एवरेज, एवरेज करना है. एवरेज मतलब यहां पे कितने का टोटल किया हमने? तीन तीन का. सो ये जो 342 आया विल बी डिवाइडेड बाय व्हाट? 3. सो आंसर फॉर दिस इज 114. नेक्स्ट है 349 टोटल आया था, उसको भी डिवाइड करेंगे बाय व्हाट? 3. सो 349 डिवाइडेड बाय 3, सो इट इज 116.3333 आ रहा है. नेक्स्ट है 353 डिवाइडेड बाय 3, सो आंसर फॉर दिस इज 117
0.666.
357 divided by 3, ये हो जाएगा 119. Then it is 361 divided by 3, ये हो जाएगा 120.333. ठीक है, तो ये हो गए वैल्यूज एंड दिस इज द वे वी फाइंड व्हाट थ्री ईयरली मूविंग एवरेजेस के सम्स. सो यहाँ पे बेसिकली ये दो वैल्यूज ऑलरेडी हमारे पास रहेंगे एंड ये दो वैल्यूज हमें ढूंढने होंगे. With the help of this, this question is done. We'll make a note of this question. Next question, that is question number 3. So again, this is based on what? Moving average. I'll read the question. Find the trend for the following data by calculating 3-yearly moving average. Bullet. Year diya and production. So, sabse pehle yahan pe likhenge year. यहां पे लिखा जाएगा प्रोडक्शन. सो यहां पे ईयर इज 1999, 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005. ठीक है, अभी प्रोडक्शन के वैल्यूज दिए. आई से इट इज 37, उसके बाद है 45, 52, 42, 58, 63, 50. आफ्टर दिस आई विल राइट इट इज 3-yearly मूविंग एवरेज ढूंढना है, तो पहले 3-yearly टोटल ढूंढना होगा और उसके बाद 3-yearly मूविंग एवरेज. सो यहां पे एक चीज समझना है, 3-yearly टोटल, तो इसका टोटल कहां पे लिखना है, तो मैं बोलूंगा 1, 2, 3, ये 3 years को हम ऐड करेंगे. तो मैं बोलूंगा ये 3 years को ऐड नहीं करेंगे, 3 years के वैल्यू को ऐड करेंगे एंड उसका वैल्यू लिखा जाएगा इन फ्रंट ऑफ व्हाट द मिडल ईयर. तो 1999, 2000, 2001, ये तीन का मिडल ईयर कौन सा, तो मैं बोलूंगा 2000. तो पहले एक काम करते, 37 प्लस 45 प्लस 52, इसको लिखते हैं एज 134 एंड इसका वैल्यू 134 कहां पे लिखा जाएगा, तो मैं बोलूंगा मिडल ऑफ द ईयर. 1999, 2000, 2001 का मिडल ईयर कौन सा है, 2000. नेक्स्ट है 2000, 2001, 2002, इसका मिडल ईयर आ जाएगा 2001. तो अभी क्या करना होगा, 45, 52 एंड 42. तो 45 प्लस 52 प्लस 42, ये ऐड किया, इसको लिस्ट किया एज 139 आया. नेक्स्ट है 2001, 2002, 2003, तो मैं बोलूंगा 52, 42, 58. तो 52 प्लस 42 प्लस 58, ये हो जाएगा 152. नेक्स्ट है 2002, 2003, 2004, तो मैं बोलूंगा इट इज 42 प्लस 58 प्लस 63, ये हो जाएगा 163. नेक्स्ट इज 58, 63 एंड 50, ये हो जाएगा 171. अब इसके बाद देखते हैं, तो 4, 5 बट 6 नहीं है, मतलब यहाँ पे इसके आगे ये वैल्यू नहीं आ सकते, तो मैं बोलूंगा फर्स्ट वैल्यू में डैश आ जाएगा और लास्ट वैल्यू में डैश आ जाएगा क्योंकि उसका एवरेज नहीं हो सकता है. सो यहाँ पे ये 3-yearly टोटल हो गया. अब मेरे को इसको 134 को डिवाइड करूंगा बाय व्हाट, 3, ये हो जाएगा 44.666, ये भी डैश आ जाएगा और ये भी क्या आ जाएगा, डैश. अभी 6666 आ रहा है तो इसको मैं राउंड ऑफ करके 44.67 बोल सकता हूं. नेक्स्ट है 139 डिवाइड बाय 3, ये हो जाएगा 46.333. नेक्स्ट है 152 डिवाइड बाय 3, ये हो जाएगा 50.666, जिसको मैं राउंड ऑफ करके 67 लिखूंगा. नेक्स्ट है 163 डिवाइड बाय 3, अब ये हो जाएगा 54.33. नेक्स्ट है 171 डिवाइड बाय 3, ये हो जाएगा 57. ठीक है, So with this, this question is done. We'll make a note of this question. Next question, question number 4. Find 3-yearly moving average just for the following time series of the company bullet. Year and export is given. I'll write it over here. It is question number 4. I'll write it as year. I'll write it as what? Export. Now 3-yearly bola hai, to yahan pe main likhunga 3-yearly total aa jayega and uske baad aa jayega 3-yearly moving average. So over here the values are, it is 2000, year is 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006. ठीक है, ये values दिए. Export के values दिए गए. It is 46, 53, 72, 57, 62, 78, 60. Now, ये जो value है, ये values already table में दिए. Now, since it is 3-yearly related question, तो 3-yearly total, ये extra column है और 3-yearly moving average, ये extra column है. अब, since 2000, 2001, 2002, ये 3 साल का total करूंगा, ये total लिखना कहां पर है, तो जो middle year है, उसके सामने लिखना, बोलूंगा 46, 53, 72, ये 3 को add करेंगे, ये 3 का addition लिखना कहां पर है, तो मैं बोलूंगा 2001 के सामने, so yeah, I will write it as 46, plus 53, plus 72, so ये हो जाएगा, 171, next है, 53, 72, 57. तो मैं लिखूंगा 53, 72, 57. 182. तो ये आ जाएगा 2002 के सामने. अब आएगा 2002, 2003, 2004. वैल्यू आ जाएगा 2003 के सामने. So now I will say it is 72 plus 57 plus 62. So ये हो जाएगा 191. उसके बाद है 57, 62, 78. I'll say it is 57, 62, 78. Ye ho jayega 197. Uske baad 62, 78, 60. Ye ho jayega 200. Theek hai, ab iske baad main bolunga ye value dash aa jayega, ye value dash aa jayega kyunki isme 3 saal hai hi nahi. Ab idhar bhi dash aa jayega aur idhar bhi kya aa jayega dash. Ab 171 divide by 3 karenge. So, ये हो जाएगा 57. Next is 182 divided by 3. So, it is 60.666 आ रहा है, which is 67 लिखूंगा. It is 191 divided by 3 बोलूंगा. ये हो जाएगा 63.666, which is 67 लिखूंगा. 197 divided by 3 बोलूंगा. It is 65.666, मतलब 67. 200 divided by 3 ये हो जाएगा 66.666 मतलब ये हो जाएगा 67. With this question number 4 is done. We'll start with the next question, that is question number 5. Now question number 5 says obtain moving averages of length 5 for the following time series representing sales in lakhs of rupees during the year 1996 to 2004. अब ये जो वैल्यू है इट इज 5-yearly बोला है, ठीक है, 3-yearly एंड 5-yearly के लिए द प्रोसीजर इज समवॉट सेम, खाली थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस है, ठीक है. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल राइट ओवर ईयर हियर एंड यहां पे मैं लिखूंगा सेल्स, ठीक है, ये दो वैल्यूज लिखना है. नाउ दिस इज क्वेश्चन विच इज बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट, 5-yearly, तो मैं एटलीस्ट यहां पे वैल्यू लिख के लिखता हूं, इट इज 5-yearly टोटल. And यहाँ पे मैं लिखता हूँ 5-yearly
moving average.
ठीक है, द ईयर इज 1996 से स्टार्ट हो रहा है, तो आई राइट ओवर ईयर 1996, उसके बाद आ जाएगा 97, 98, 99, 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, 2000 क्या आएगा 4. ठीक है, तो यहां पे मैं लिख देता हूं 1990, ये जाएगा 2000, उसके बाद 57 है, उसके बाद 60 है, आफ्टर दैट इट इज 55, 59, 62, 68. ठीक है, ये सेट ऑफ वैल्यूज ही है. नाउ दिस इज गिवन कंडीशन, ये गिवन है. अब ये क्वेश्चन 5 ईयरली का है, तो मुझे एक चीज समझना है. जब 3 ईयरली था तो हम लोग क्या करते थे, 3 साल का टोटल लिखते थे, ऐड करते थे और उसको मिडल ऑफ द ईयर में लिखते थे. अब यहां पे 5 ईयरली बोला है तो 5 साल, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 साल का टोटल करेगा और वहां उसको कहां पर लिखेंगे, तो मैं बोलूंगा उसके मिडल में. तो मैं ऐसा बोलूंगा 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 पोजीशंस को अगर मैंने ऐड किया तो 5 पोजीशंस मतलब 1 + 2 = 3 हो जाएगा, 3 + 3 = 6 हो जाएगा, 6 + 4 = 10 हो जाएगा, 10 + 5 = 15 हो जाएगा. तो 15 को डिवाइड बाय 5 किया तो ये हो जाएगा एज व्हाट, 3. सो मिडल ईयर मतलब 1998 हो जाएगा. ठीक है, तो ये 5 साल के टोटल करना है, तो मैं बता रहा हूं यहां पे इट इज 51 है प्लस 50 है, सॉरी 51 है प्लस 53 है प्लस 50 प्लस 57 प्लस 60. तो ये 5 साल के टोटल को ऐड करके लिखूंगा कहां पे, तो मैं बोलूंगा 3rd ईयर के सामने, दैट इज 1998. तो इसका टोटल आ रहा है 271. अब हर बार मैं ये हर चीज नहीं कर सकता, तो मैं क्या करूंगा, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ये 5 साल के टोटल किया, ये 5 साल के टोटल को लिखा किधर, उसके मिडल ऑफ द ईयर में. अरे 96, 97, 98, 99 और 2000, ये 5 साल का एवरेज क्या हो जाएगा, 1998. तो उसके सामने मैंने उसका टोटल लिखा. अब मैं क्या करूंगा, मैं बोलूंगा इधर से 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, तो मैं ऐसा बोलूंगा 55 को ऐड करूंगा और 51 को सबट्रैक्ट करूंगा. तो मैं क्या करूंगा, 271 में से 55 ऐड करूंगा और 51 को माइनस करूंगा. तो आई विल से 271 प्लस 55 माइनस 51. सो मुझे आंसर मिल जाएगा एज व्हाट, 275. एंड ये मैं कहां पर लिखूंगा, तो 1999 के सामने. अब मैं रिपीट करता हूं वापस से. अब मैं ऐसा बोलूंगा 275 इधर तक का टोटल है, मैं ऐसा बोलूंगा 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 उसका टोटल यहां पर. अब 59 को ऐड करूंगा और 53 को माइनस करूंगा. तो 59 को ऐड किया माइनस 53 किया, सो ये आंसर आ जाएगा 281. ठीक है, अब नेक्स्ट क्या करूंगा, 62 को ऐड करूंगा और 50 को माइनस करूंगा. तो 281 प्लस 62 माइनस 50 हो जाएगा 293. नेक्स्ट मैं ऐसा बोलूंगा 68 को ऐड करूंगा और 57 को माइनस करूंगा. 293 प्लस 68 माइनस 57. ठीक है, तो ये हो जाएगा 304. अब यहां पे एक चीज समझना है, पहले दो पे डैश आएगा तो लास्ट के दो पे भी क्या आएगा, डैश. तो यहां पे भी क्या आएगा, डैश लास्ट के दो. अब ये जो 271 है इसको डिवाइड करेंगे बाय व्हाट, 5, क्योंकि ये 5 ईयरली मूविंग एवरेज है. तो 271 डिवाइड बाय क्या करूंगा, 5, ये हो जाएगा 54. अब 275 डिवाइड बाय 5 ये हो जाएगा 55. नेक्स्ट है 281 डिवाइड बाय 5 ये हो जाएगा 56.2. 293 डिवाइड बाय 5 ये हो जाएगा 58.6. 304 डिवाइड बाय 5 ये हो जाएगा 60.8. विद दिस क्वेश्चन इज डन. नाउ दिस वाज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन which was based on what, 5 yearly moving average. Okay, we'll make a note of this question, these two questions, and over here, before the next session, please revise जो भी हमने 3 early and 5 early के procedure है वो, so that next time when we do questions based on 5 early, we get a overview of this. ठीक है, thank you.